Hey everyone and welcome to Leo's Tech Corner. Today I'll be showing you this tiny, low-cost 5-port gigabit managed switch from TP-Link. So let's get started. This switch is a member of the 100 series family. TP-Link 100 series switches are very affordable and they often have some really nice features. For example, this one, like I said in the intro, has a management interface. There are also models with PoE capabilities, but also unmanaged super affordable models such as the standard SG105. Before I show you the switch itself, let's decode the model number, which can help while deciding between different models. So the TL is just short for TP-Link. The S in SG means it's a network switch, and the G means it supports 1 gigabit connections. The 105 can be split between the 1, which is the series, and the 05, which is the number of ports, so in this case it's 5. Then there are letters and combinations of them. The most common you can find right now are E, for easy smart switch, which is a fancy way of saying less management features for lower price. D, for desktop, those are standard switches in a glossy plastic finish. P, for PoE capable switch, and M2, which means it's a 2.5 gigabit switch. As I said, you can also find combinations such as DL-SG105PE, which is both a PoE and an easy smart switch in one. Now, let's finally unbox this one and I'll show you what's inside the box. So, inside the box you're going to find the switch itself, some manuals, and the power adapter. Sadly, there's no Ethernet cable in the box, so you'll have to find one yourself. If we take a look at the switch, we can see that on the front there are 5 Ethernet ports with the speed indicator right on them. On the sides, there are some ventilation holes for passive cooling, and on the back, as is standard with these tiny switches, we get a DC power jack. Now, let's plug it in and I'm going to show you the main feature of this switch, the management interface. As I've previously said, I'm going to show you how to get to the management interface of this switch. So first, you have to find the IP address. You can log into your router and find it there, or if you don't have access to your router's management, there's a handy app called Advanced IP Scanner, which can help. It is free, but you can only download it for Windows. In my case, the IP address is 192.168.1.24. Yours may be different. Now type the IP address into your web browser, and there it is. Default credentials are admin for the username and admin for the password. Once you log in, you're in the dashboard with the basic info about IP settings, firmware versions, and others. When you click a tab, you'll get more settings. For example, under the System tab, you can find IP settings and also things like config backups, manual reboot, and firmware update. Under the Switching tab, you can find settings for individual ports, IGMP snooping, and link aggregation group or lag. You can also see port statistics, set up VLANs, manage quality of service. There are a lot of options for a $25 switch. And that wraps it up for today. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask in the comments. If you like the video, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.